Rasagiline is an irreversible inhibitor of monoamine oxidase used for the symptomatic management of idiopathic Parkinson's disease as initial monotherapy and as adjunct therapy to levodopa. In this video, let's find found. What is rasagiline? What is rasagiline used for? Contraindication. What are the side effects of taking rasagiline? How does rasagiline work? How to use rasagiline? What is rasagiline? Rasagiline is an irreversible inhibitor of monoamine oxidase B used as a monotherapy to treat symptoms in early Parkinson's disease or as an adjunct therapy in more advanced cases. The racemic form of the drug was invented by Azipron in the early 1970s. Musa BH Teva brought it to market in partnership with Lundbeck in Europe and Eisai in the US and elsewhere. It was approved in Europe in 2005 and in the US in 2006. What is rasagiline used for? For the treatment of the signs and symptoms of idiopathic Parkinson's disease as initial monotherapy and as adjunct therapy to levodopa. Contraindication. Rasagiline tablets are contraindicated for use with St. John's wort and with cyclobenzaprine. Rasagiline tablets are contraindicated for use with dextromethorphan because of risk of an episode of psychosis or bizarre behavior. Exacerbation of hypertension may occur during treatment with rasagiline tablets. Side effects. Side effects when the drug is taken alone include flu-like symptoms, joint pain, depression, stomach upset, headache, dizziness, and insomnia. When taken with L-DOPA, side effects include increased movement problems, accidental injury, sudden drops in blood pressure, joint pain and swelling, dry mouth, rash, abnormal dreams and digestive problems including vomiting, loss of appetite, weight loss, abdominal pain, nausea, constipation. When taken with Parkinson's drugs other than L-DOPA, side effects include peripheral edema, fall, joint pain, cough, and insomnia. Pharmacodynamic. Rasagiline is a propargylamine and an irreversible inhibitor of monoamine oxidase, MAO. MAO, a flavin-containing enzyme, regulates the metabolic degradation of catecholamines and serotonin in the CNS and peripheral tissues. It is classified into major molecular species, A and B, and is localized in mitochondrial membranes throughout the body in nerve terminals, brain, liver, and intestinal mucosa. MAOA is found predominantly in the GI tract and liver, and regulates the metabolic degradation of circulating catecholamines and dietary amines. MAOB is the major form in the human brain and is responsible for the regulation of the metabolic degradation of dopamine and phenylethylamine. In ex vivo animal studies in brain, liver, and intestinal tissues, rasagiline was shown to be a potent, selective, and irreversible monoamine oxidase type B, MAOB, inhibitor. At the recommended therapeutic doses, rasagiline was also shown to be a potent and irreversible inhibitor of MAOB in platelets. The selectivity of rasagiline for inhibiting only MAOB and not MAOA in humans and the sensitivity to tyramine during rasagiline treatment at any dose has not sufficiently characterized to avoid restriction of dietary tyramine and amines contained in medications. Mechanism of action. The precise mechanisms of action of rasagiline is unknown. One mechanism is believed to be related to its MAOB inhibitory activity, which causes an increase in extracellular levels of dopamine in the striatum. The elevated dopamine level and subsequent increased dopaminergic activity are likely to mediate rasagiline's beneficial effects seen in models of dopaminergic motor dysfunction. Half-life. Rasagiline has a mean steady-state half-life of 3 hours, but there is no correlation of pharmacokinetics with its pharmacological effect because of its irreversible inhibition of MAOB. Dose. Parkinson disease. Monotherapy, 1 mg POQ day. Adjunct without levodopa, 1 mg POQ day. Adjunct to levodopa, 0.5 mg POQ day initially, may increase to 1 mg per day if needed and tolerated, consider reducing levodopa dose. Safety advice. US FDA pregnancy category C, Animal reproduction studies have shown an adverse effect on the fetus, and there are no adequate and well-controlled studies in humans, but potential benefits may warrant use of the drug in pregnant women despite potential risks. That's all the information about Rasagiline we collected. Thanks for listening. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe for the HeInfo channel if you like this video to update more health information.